whenever I am speaking in the presence of listening, which is there in the room right now, like we worked on it since the beginning, and all of us giving our commitment, saying we'll be in the space of integrity, authenticity, responsibility, right? So each one of us, by giving that word to us and to the group, we have actually caused, we have created a certain kind of authentic listening in this room. We have actually, what we have done is we have created a certain space for an authentic listening to happen. Little later in the program, when we come to that part, we'll come to communication, where we'll learn more deeper findings, we'll have revelations, discoveries about authentic listening. But for now, let's understand that the space in this room is different. It's not usually how it is outside. Usually outside, people have their own way of listening, isn't it? Yes or no? Usually outside, people are listening with what? As I was telling in the morning, from filters which are mostly given by patterns. And we don't even know we are run by our patterns. But here, what is happening inside the program, consciously, we are all saying, we'll be in integrity, we'll be in authenticity, we'll take responsibility for everyone, for me and others. So just inside of those simple commitments that we have made, the listening in this room has now shifted. Now you don't have an ordinary listening, you have a very profound, deep listening in the room. In this listening, when you declare something, when you share something, what will happen? What do you think will happen? It becomes the truth. Exactly. It becomes reality. So if you have to cause miracles out there in the world, if you want to do whatever you want in your life, if you want to make that as a reality, work for the listening to get created first. And with whatever work has happened in the program in the past 5 days, the listening in this room has altered. For me, for you, for each one of us. So inside of this space of listening, when you declare now, means when you share something now, you will see that very declaration that you make becomes very powerful. It gains its own strength. It becomes, starts becoming reality. Are we getting this? Is everybody getting this? Because the listening is different in this room. That's why what you're going to declare is going to be powerful. For example, if you were in a court and the judge is saying something, there's a final verdict being given in some issue. And when the judge says, now I give you a life sentence. Now, isn't that a reality? Does anyone have a doubt about that? They can appeal against it. But does anybody have a question about that? It's not going to happen? It's happening the moment the judge pronounces, I give you life sentence. I give you this punishment. Why? Why is it powerful? On the road, if somebody tells me, hey, I'm giving you a life sentence, will you even bother about it? Then what is different in a courtroom? Exactly. Say it again. It is said with authority, but it's not even because it is said with authority. No. Yes, the listening is there for the authority. He said in another way, there is a listening in a courtroom which is not there on the road. Yes or no? If in the house, wife or husband says, hey, I'm giving you a punishment, you'll say, get lost. Who are you to give me a punishment? I'll give you 10 punishments. Before they beat me, I'll beat them. You can't do that with a judge. What is different? The same you in the court will be different because your listening is different in a courtroom. Are you guys getting this? Why do people go to church? Why do we go to temple? Why not we stand in the, you know, anywhere randomly and do the same thing we do in a temple or a church? Because there is more listening for something called prayer or worship to happen in a place called temple. Do you understand? And that listening obviously translates into the energy that vibrates in that place. Of course, it's slightly different with places like temple and church because, yes, it has a mystical aspect too. But if you take a day-to-day living example like the judge I said or like the priest who pronounces the wedding, The priest in most religions, there's a priest, right, who conducts the wedding. So if the priest or the father says, "Now I pronounce you man and wife," do you have any question about it? Do you behave differently after that? No. You actually behave from that moment as man and wife. Till then, you may not be bound by that. Why? Because there is a listening for that person, for that priest, for that father. Inside of the listening, when he utters those words become a reality for life. Are we getting this? Do you understand this? So that's how powerful listening is. Now, inside the space of listening in this room, when we declare something, knowing that there is a listening for this something to become a reality, you will just see simply it will start getting fulfilled in your life. Clear? Any questions on declaration? Any questions? So what is it that makes a declaration powerful? Exactly. Not the language, not the words that you're using, not your body language. All of that is secondary. Primarily, what is it that causes declaration to become a reality? The listening that is provided for that declaration makes the declaration powerful. Did we get this? Okay. So what we'll do now for the first part. First, we'll sit with a partner. Sit with someone you may have not sat till now. Okay. It can be a person. Obviously, it's not like yesterday's process. So today you will sit with a person who knows the language, who can understand the language. Sit with one person, and the first, please listen before we start doing this. I'll just finish the instructions. The first part, even before sitting with a partner, look at all the list of your desires. Does everyone has a list? Some will have more, some will have less. We have a list, right? So in that list, look at what are the various desires you now know you don't want to hold on to. You know, you are completing themselves for you and you're dropping them. Can I have desires which I want to drop? I may have a desire and now I know that maybe I don't want it anymore. It has been there, but let me complete and drop it. So look at, you need not have, by the way, you may have, you may not have, but if you have any desire that you now think you can complete and you can drop and move further, you know, mark it off, strike it off. Clear? Strike it off. Strike off all the desires you think you don't want to pursue anymore in your life. At this point, you know, you feel you should drop it. Remove that. Then, look at the other desires. If you have any more desires left, then declare to your partner. When you sit with your partner, declare completion, fulfillment of those desires happening. So declare. For example, if you're saying, I am owning a big house. If you're declaring that you're going to make that desire a reality, declare that in the listening of your partner. I am now living in a big house. And this desire I'm declaring is going to get completed, is being fulfilled for me in my life. It's like a declaration you're making towards fulfillment of that desire. If you don't want that desire, you are very clear, I'm going to drop it. I don't want to have this anymore in my life. Then to yourself, you will complete. You know, it's like a self-declaration you'll do. I am completing this. I am dropping this. I am not going to hold on to this desire anymore. Do we get this? This is a very powerful process. Why? Because so far, desire was holding us. Now, with consciously looking into it and creating a declaration in a listening, I will hold the desire. Obviously, the second state is more powerful, isn't it? When I hold the desire, I am not a slave. I am the master of the desire. So I won't suffer in the process and I'll get what I want. But when the desire is holding me, what is happening? When something is possessing me, when the desire, something like a desire is possessing me, what's happening? I have become a slave to that and I, in the process of getting or not getting it, I'm suffering. Is this clear? What do we do with conflicting desires? Same thing. Just look in and see, what is it that you really want? What is the one thing you want in it? What is it that you want to retain? What is it that you want to drop? You want to share an example? You have anything like that, or you think you'll work it out?
Now, I'm a student. I'm doing chartered accountancy.
Closer into the mic.
Yeah. So after finishing my chartered accountancy, I have two options: going for employment or practicing myself. Like, I'm not clear about that. I know, like, I have a desire for both, but I don't know which to pick.
Okay. Like, so what will you do now? Consider this. See, one is whether you want to continue. You want to go for working. Am I right? One is you'll complete the studies, whatever is the course, and you now want to, you're at a crossroads. A crossroads whether I need to work for someone or do a business kind of a thing. Like, you know, start up my own firm, isn't it? So when you look at both the options, individually look at both of them. Don't connect both of them. Separate both of them as two different aspects. Look at them till the completion. Meaning, look at each of it knowing that it has already happened. Are you getting what I'm saying? Go get into that. This moment is about the future you're living into, right? Already now, go into the future and walk back to this moment. If you were working, for example, under someone, see what's happening to you now. Right now you're working under someone. Then what is that taking you to? What would be the experience you would be left with when you're working with someone? It could be, you know, you'll be getting up and going by a certain time to a certain place, working with them, then getting appraisal, or then, you know, moving with whatever is their expectation about what you're doing. Then maybe you'll have offs, you know, weekend holidays, this and that, and compensations and incentives. So there's a whole world of reality out there connected to that desire. Am I right? Live that fully. Just know right now that's happening and just relive that whole situation. Just like how you relive the past, relive the future of this situation. And come back to the present and see, this is what I'll be left with. The next option is what? Suppose you're speaking about running your own business. Again, look into the whole future about that. Now, if I am running, then there's nobody even guiding me. Nobody under whom I will be. There'll be people under me. And the consequences will be what? I may not probably end up getting an off, isn't it? Because nobody will give me an off. I have to take off from the work myself. And probably there's no weekend concept, like, you know, completely, which can be there if it's option one. However, this is what I'll be left with: more freedom or more money or more creativity. So whatever you think is there when you take this to when you take that, consequentially walk into the future as an as-lived experience, and you will just get the clarity when you bring that kind of minute awareness to both. Are you getting this? Oh, you are only the judge for what is it that you really want. So sit with both of them, separately relive them, as if it's happened, you know, and then look at what you will be going through as an experience, and then you'll be able to take a call. You can declare, yes. And even after you declare, if you still have a confusion, obviously you can ask Swamiji always in Energy Darshan. You know, you can write both the options and tell Swamiji in the Darshan, he will tell you at the end, okay, do this or do that. But if you have clarity before that, good. Yes, ma'am. Yes, chips, if you have anything. I would ask you to keep it aside for now, because we have an exclusive session on relationships. We have a very deep, really profound session on relationships. So we'll exclusively, specially work on it. There's a special dedicated program on relationships. So if it is something related to relationship, probably for now, leave it aside. Just because we are going to go back and work on it. Yeah. So concentrate maybe on all other desires. I know I didn't give you the answer, but I gave you the answer. No? So temporarily it's good. So let the desire be there, let the partner be there, let them both live with each other for now. And then we'll go back and see what to do. Do you drop the desire, do you drop the partner, or do you drop the conflict? We'll see that when we get to relationships. But good question, thank you.